The South African Democratic Teachers Union is convening its 9th National Congress in Johannesburg this morning. It meets at least once in 5 years to elect new leadership and adopt policies by means of resolutions. President Cyril Ramaphosa, Minister of Basic Education, Angie Motshekga, and leaders from the Tripartite Alliance will address the Congress.
We are going to be listening to the comrade Malerato Musiane from the States of South Africa. We must just correct from the bio there. She has been with the institution for 19 years, well experienced in terms of labor statistics. She's now the acting chief director as part of the top management of this institute. So without much ado, let me invite Malerato to come and address us about the issues of unemployment and education, and how education can really play a role in addressing the issues of unemployment. Malerato, over to you. Thank you.
I'll be taking you through the presentation that looks at economy, education, and unemployment. As of the mid-2019, there were 58.78 million people living in South Africa. And of this, there was an increase of about 1.2 million due to people who were born between last year and the current year. And we had about 200,000 people who moved into the country from other countries, and migration contributed 200,000. And deaths, we have seen 500,000 people dying between the 2 years, 2018 and 2019. And South Africa is a youthful population where we have more than 60% of the population being aged between the ages of 0 and 34. And we only have about 5.3 million people who are over the age of 60. More than half of the population resides in the three provinces, that is Gauteng, KwaZulu-Natal, and Western Cape, where Gauteng accounts for 25.8% of the total population of the country, and the Northern Cape only contributes 2.2% of the population. At the national level, we have about a third of children who are living with both of their parents. However, we have about 43% of these children living with only their mothers. And if you look at Eastern Cape, 33.1% of children lived with neither of their parents. And the majority of children who are aged between 0 and 4 are still at home. They are not in our ECD centers, where you see in Gauteng, 36.8% of children are still at home, not in ECD centers. However, Gauteng has the highest share of children aged 0 to 4 who are also in these centers, 49.8%. Nearly half of these children who are 0 to 4 years have never read a book with their parents. The parents indicated that they don't read books to their children. And even just drawing with them, we have 43.1% of parents that indicated that they don't engage their children in terms of drawing with them. And they don't even read stories or tell stories to them. About 35.1% of parents indicated they don't tell stories to their children. And we also have a noticeable representation of learners who are older than the ideal graduation date. As you can see, we still have about children who are aged 17 to 18 who graduate primary school level. And even at secondary, you'd expect the 24-year-olds to be in tertiary education or at least working, but we still see some of these children completing their secondary education at the age of 24. Over a fifth of our learners cited that they are not in school due to lack of funds. There's no money to pay school fees. And we have seen some gender disparities in terms of the reasons that these children gave for not being in school, where you see more girl children indicating that they are not in school because of family commitments, and compared to boys that indicated that education is useless. We have a higher proportion of boys indicating that education is useless. If you look at the differences according to population groups, we have seen that among Black African young people, 53% did not go to school because of a lack of funds, compared to 20.5% among their white counterparts. And if you look at those who are not in school because they have completed their education, 71.7% among whites indicated they have completed their education, that is why they are not in school, compared to 16.3% among Black children. In terms of those who complete matric, we have seen the percentage of those who have their highest level of education as matric increasing between 2012 and 2018, where it increased from 21.3% in 2012 to 30.9% in 2018. And most of the provinces, if you look at those people who complete matric at the national level, we are sitting at 30.89%. And only Gauteng, KwaZulu-Natal, and Mpumalanga have percentages higher than the national average. And in terms of post-school, only Gauteng, Western Cape have percentages that are over the national average of 14.3%. And the percentage of those who are enrolled in higher education institutions has been increasing over time, where we have seen an increase of 38% between 2000 and 2008, and an increase of 22% between the years 2008 and 2016. And in terms of enrollment, the TVET colleges are accommodating about 700,000 students. Community education and training institutions accommodate about 273,000 people, and the private colleges accommodating 168,000 people. That is as of 2016. And this has increased for both TVET and private colleges. However, for community education and training centers, there has been a decline from 297,000 in 2010 to 273,000 in 2016. Now, moving to the economy. South Africa has experienced a lot of recessions since 1961. There's been about 8 of them, with the most recent ones being the one we experienced between 2008 and 2009, and the one we had recently in 2018. In terms of the sectors or the industries that contribute to the GDP, in terms of their ranking, in 1994, manufacturing used to account for 21% of national GDP, and it was ranked first. But by 2018, it had moved to the fourth spot, whereby we have now seen finance taking the first spot, accounting for 20% of the GDP. Now, looking in terms of the contribution of these industries to GDP relative to their shares in employment, we have seen trade, construction, and agriculture having higher employment shares compared to their GDP contribution. As you may be aware, the unemployment rate in South Africa is currently sitting at 29%. I don't know why it's not showing there, but it's 29%. And this rate has been high since the quarterly labor force survey was started in 2008. It has been hovering between 23 and 29%. We have about 38.4 million people of working age. That is those who are aged between the ages of 15 and 64. And of those, 23 million are active in the labor market. Either they are employed or unemployed. And we had about 16.3 million people who were employed as of the second quarter of 2019, and 6.7 million people unemployed, translating to the unemployment rate of 29%. And we have the other group of people who are not in the labor force. And of those 15.5 million people who are not in the labor force, 2.7 million are not in the labor force because they are discouraged. Either there are no jobs in the areas where they live, or there are no jobs requiring their skills, or they have lost hope of finding any kind of work. And this number has declined by about 400,000 between the first quarter and the second quarter of 2019. And we have two definitions of unemployment, the official definition and the expanded definition of unemployment. According to the official definition, for one to be unemployed, you should be without work in the reference week, should have looked for work and be available to take that job if it's offered to you, or if conditions allow, you'll be able to start a business. But according to the expanded definition, we don't consider the job search criterion. As long as you indicated you are available for work, then you're regarded as unemployed. And we have seen the expanded unemployment rate sitting at 35% as of 39.5% as of the second quarter of 2019. And in terms of gender disparities, the unemployment rate, irrespective of which definition you use, is highest among women than among men. If we look at the provincial picture, we have seen Limpopo having the lowest unemployment rate according to the official definition, and Eastern Cape having the highest at 35.4%. But if you look at the expanded definition, that is the mustard color, Limpopo has an unemployment rate of 41.1%. So it doesn't necessarily mean people don't want jobs, but maybe they don't look, or they are discouraged because there are no jobs in the areas where they live, or no jobs that require their skills. Now, looking at the unemployment rate by education, the unemployment rate is lowest among those who are graduates at 9.1%, and it increases with the lower the level of education, the higher the unemployment rate. And the higher the unemployment rate, the lower the absorption rate and the participation rate, and vice versa. For instance, those graduates who have the unemployment rate of 9.1% is because most of them have jobs and they are absorbed in the labor market, hence the high absorption rate of 80.6%. And they are also participating in the labor market in terms of having jobs or looking for jobs. Then the unemployment rate is highest among those aged 15 to 24, at 56.4%. And also unemployment rate declines with age. The older you get, the better chances you have of getting employment, hence the lower unemployment rate as you grow older. Then the unemployment rate among youth, irrespective of their education level, is the highest. The figures have disappeared. I don't know where they have gone, but if you look at the bars, among those who are 15 to 24 years, the unemployment rate is the lowest. If you look at the bar, it's shorter than the rest of the other educational categories. Irrespective of your age, if you are a graduate, the unemployment rate within that particular age group is lowest compared to people with other education levels within that age group. And black women are still vulnerable in the labor market in South Africa, where the unemployment rate among black women is above 30%, both in the first quarter of 2019 and the second quarter. And black people and colored people are also vulnerable in the labor market, irrespective of their sex, whether they are male or female. As long as you're black or colored, the unemployment rate among these population groups is higher compared to the Indian and white population groups. Now, in terms of skills for those who are employed, we have seen an improvement between 1994 and 2017. However, for those 15 to 24 who are black African, we have seen that there has been a decline in terms of the skill level between those who are 15 to 34. If you look at the gray bars, they are longer for the other population groups, but if you look at the bottom one for the black Africans, the gray bar is shorter than the blue bar. Then we have another group of young people who are not in employment and education, who are disengaged from both work and education. And we have seen, we had about 10.3 million young people aged between the ages of 15 and 24 as of the second quarter of 2019. And of those, 32.3% were not in employment, education, or training. And the NEET rate is higher among females than among males. Looking at the provincial picture, Northern Cape had the highest NEET rate among those 15 to 24 years in the second quarter of 2019, and Limpopo had the lowest. And only Gauteng, Western Cape, and Limpopo had the NEET rates lower than the national average. And in terms of those who are 15 to 34, we have two age groups, 15 to 24 for international comparisons, but in South Africa, youth is regarded as those who are below the age of 35. Hence, we also have this slide to see how they are performing in the labor market and in terms of their need. And we had about 20.4 million young people in this age group, and 40.3% of them were not in employment, education, or training. And we are also seeing a similar picture in terms of gender differences, where the NEET rate is highest among females compared to males. The provincial picture, we are seeing Northwest having the highest NEET rate, and the Western Cape having the lowest NEET rate of 32.6%. And the same provinces, as we have seen in the previous slide, where we're looking at the 15 to 24, the same provinces have NEET rates lower than the national average. And when people don't have jobs, they try and survive. And we have another survey that we run that looks at the informal sector, where we look at people running businesses that are not registered for value-added tax. And of the people who were running these businesses, 63.5% of them indicated that they started these businesses because they don't have jobs or they don't have alternative sources of income. And in 2001, we had these people, 2.3 million of such people running informal sector businesses, and the number declined to 1.8 million in 2017. In terms of their age groups, we have seen less than 1% of young people aged between 15 and 24 starting their small businesses in order to survive compared to the other age groups. And we have seen a bigger share among those who are aged 45 and 54 years, that is 8.1%, followed by those 35 to 34 years. And in terms of profits, we have seen these businesses not really making lots of profits. And those that are making a profit of between 751 and 3,000 account for 39% of these people that are running informal sector businesses. And only about 14% make profits of more than 6,000 rand a month. And that is the end of my presentation. Thank you.
Munalitsa ebe ukwele, those who with ears have heard that the scourge of joblessness has to be confronted. So these statistics were not just numbers for you to hear what is happening. It's how in our resolutions do we make sure that joblessness is fought for what it is.